and of our dialogue with China. Because after all, this is not something which can define the boundaries of a border. If that was so, India's ethnic and religious reach in the olden times covered the entire Southeast Asia and even beyond. That doesn't mean that it's all part of India. So therefore, the concept of these borders which came up during the colonial period and Cold War, it got sharpened further, had to be relooked at, and perhaps there is something unconsciously or otherwise happening in this regard. But having said all this, I don't think we can wish away and run away from the fact that we have to match and bridge this gap across the whole spectrum of national capabilities vis-à-vis China. Even negotiations normally take place amongst equals, and therefore we have to have a balanced posture, not only military posture, but our overall posture vis-à-vis China. And then, and only then we'll have enough leverage. I think there is a movement in this regard as well. I think, in brief, this is what I wanted to say. And by way of conclusion, I would say that connectivity promotes development through regional integration and enhances security. Because the link between connectivity, security and development cannot be broken. And it generates huge economy of scale and innovation from network externalities as well. So therefore, we need to strengthen the links which are deep in all their dimensions. Because if K2K or Stillwell Road, if these two initiatives come through, 20 to 25% of bilateral trade between India and China can be done through that.